Hi everyone, it's Civil Engineering Tutorials. In this video, I'll discuss about three-phase system of soil with phase diagram. To watch all the videos on this channel, click on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get regular updates from Civil Engineering Tutorials. Also like this video in case you find it helpful. So let's get started. Phase system is represented with a phase diagram. So what is phase diagram? The representation of different phases of soil with diagram is called as phase diagram. So here we will discuss about three phase system of soil with phase diagram. So this is ground level. So below ground level, these are soil mass. A soil mass is a three phase system. If we'll take a portion of soil into a closed system, then it will look like this. This is the element of natural soil. These are the soil particles and these are known as soil solids. You can see here, these are the soil particles and these particles are known as soil solids. These are the soil solids. I have already marked these are the soil solids. You can see here. Now, these are the free space between soil solids and these free space are known as voids or void space. These are the free space between soil solids and these free space are known as voids or void space. So, the void space may be filled with water or air or is filled partly with water or partly with air. If we take dry soil mass, then the voids are filled with air only. If we take perfectly saturated soil, then the voids are completely filled with water. If we take partially saturated soil, then the voids are filled with water and air. So these are the void space. So void space may be filled with water, may be filled with air, or may be filled with both water and air. Now, if we take partially saturated soil, then the voids are filled with both water and air. So, let's see. First, we'll discuss about partially saturated soil. So this is the phase diagram of partially saturated soil. Now, if we take partially saturated soil, then the voids are filled with both water and air. This is partially saturated soil. This is the phase diagram. This is solids, VS, solids, volume of solids. These are the soil solids. This is water. You can see these are, and this is air. So, these are the free space or voids and these are soil solids. So this is the phase diagram. This is the element separated into three phases. Okay. So in partially saturated soil, the voids are filled with both water and air. So you can see this is divided into three phase system. This is the phase diagram. Solid, water and air. Now, VS is volume of solids. Here to here, this is volume of solids. VS. Now, VV, volume of voids. Here to here, this is volume of voids. Now, this is VA. VA is volume of air. This is volume of air and VW is volume of water. So, volume of air plus volume of water. So, this is volume of void. So, VW is volume of water. And VA is volume of air. So, volume of air plus volume of water is VV. So, VV, volume of void is equal to volume of water plus volume of air. VA plus VW is VV, as it is partially saturated soil. So, this is volume of water and volume of air. Volume of water plus volume of air is known as volume of void in case of partially saturated soil. So, total volume of soil mass V, here to here this is the total volume of soil mass. So, total volume is VV plus VA. Volume of voids plus volume of solid. VA plus VW, volume of void. Now, volume of void plus volume of solid is known as total volume. Hope you understand. Total volume is VV, volume of void, here to here plus here to here volume of solid. This is the total volume. So, total volume is volume of void plus volume of solids. So, it is three-phase system. Solid, water and air. This is partially saturated soil and this is the phase diagram of partially saturated soil. So, this is three-phase system. This is the phase diagram. This volume of void, this volume of solid, this volume of air, this volume of water. Okay, as it is partially saturated soil. So, this is three-phase system. So, it's solid, water and air. Now, we can represent this according to weight also. You can see here, this is weight, W. Now, this is solid, WS, water, WW. This is WS, weight of air. WV is weight of volume. So, WV is weight of voids. Sorry, weight of voids. Here to here, weight of voids. Now, WS, weight of solids. Here to here, this is weight of solids. Now, WW is weight of water. Now, WSA is weight of water. So, weight of water is considered as zero. Weight of air is considered to be negligible. So, this is zero. Weight of air is considered to be zero. So, WV is equal to WW plus WA. So, WA is zero. So, WA, weight of air, is considered to be negligible. So, it's 0. So, WV is WW, weight of water, plus WA is 0. So, weight of void is equal to weight of water according to weight for partially saturated soil. So, in this case, weight of void is equal to weight of water. So, total weight W is equal to weight of solids plus weight of water. Weight of water is equal to weight of voids. So, weight of solid plus weight of water is equal to total weight. So, this is according to weight for partially saturated soil. So, in this case, the voids are filled with both water and air. Now, if we take dry soil mass, then the voids are filled with air only. In case of fully dry soil, if we take fully dry soil mass, then the voids are filled with air only. So, this is volume of void. This is volume of air is equal to volume of void. Because in this case, voids are filled with air only. So, volume of void is equal to volume of air. This is volume of solid here to here. This is total V here to here total V. This is volume of void. Now, this void space is completely filled with air. So volume of air is equal to volume of words. So this is fully dry soil. So here elements separated into two phases, solid and air. So this is the phase diagram for fully dry soil mass. Now if we take perfectly saturated soil or fully saturated soil. So in case of perfectly saturated soil or fully saturated soil, the voids are completely filled with water. You can see here, this is volume of voids. So volume of voids are completely filled with water. This is the total volume. Now this is Vs, volume of solids. And this is volume of water. So in this case, volume of water is equal to volume of voids, as it is completely filled with water. So this is fully saturated soil. So here in this case, volume of water is equal to volume of voids. So this is also two phases. Here also elements separated into two phases. So this is two phase. So hope you understand. If you like this video, then don't forget to like and subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching.